Mathematics, probability, part 4. We're going to look at the following outline: binomial probability, and then we'll look at addition rule of binomial probability. Let's start with binomial probability. Binomial probability means probability that involves two opposite parameters that are complementary. It can be success and failure, or it can be hitting a target or missing a target. A favorable outcome in a random experiment is referred to as a success. If the outcome is not favorable, we can take it as a failure. Let probability of success be P, all right, and probability of failure be Q. This means that P plus Q is always equals to 1. Example 1. Probability that a certain student passed an examination is 0.3. What is the probability that the student failed the exam? Solution: probability of passing P is given to us as 0.3 from the question. The probability that the student failed will be 1 minus probability that he passed, okay, which will be 1 minus 0.3. That will give us probability of failure to be 0.7. Example 2. If the probability that a boy does his addition correctly is 3 over 5, what is the probability that he does the addition wrongly? Okay. Solution: we're given the probability of doing the addition correctly as 3 over 5. Then the probability that he does the addition wrongly will be 1 minus probability that he does it correctly, which will be 1 minus 3 over 5. Okay, 1 minus 3 over 5. Now we have 5 minus 3 over 5, which is the LCM. 5 minus 3 will give us 2 over 5 as our answer. Example 3. The probability that a certain student failed an examination is 2 over 5. If three students are selected at random, find the probability that they all pass the exam, they all fail the exam. At least two pass the exam. Okay, let's begin. Solution: probability that the student will fail the exam is given to us as 5 over 12. Okay, probability that he passes will be 1 minus 5 over 12, which is 7 over 12. Is that okay? So probability that all pass will be 7 over 12 times 7 over 12 times 7 over 12, since is it two, we're picking three students from the list. Okay, 7 times 7 times 7 will give us 343 over 12 times 12 times 12 will give us 1728, 1728. Probability that all fail, remember probability that the student fail is 5 over 12. So since it's three students, 5 over 12 times 5 over 12 times 5 over 12, which will give us 125 over 1728. C part, probability that at least two pass. This simply means the first two students pass, the second one fail, or the first pass, second fail, third pass, or first fail, the other two pass, or the three of them pass. That's the meaning. So the first one, 7 over 12, 7 over 12 times 5 over 12, that's 2 pass, 1 fail, plus 1 pass, 1 fail, then another pass, second bracket, plus first fail, the two next 2 passed, and then finally the 3 pass. So at least means, at least 2 means from 2 up to 3 passed. Okay, so first bracket we have 245/17/28 plus second bracket same 245/17/28 plus 245 again over 17/28 and then finally plus 343/17/28. If we add the numerator, we're going to have 1078/17/28. 2 can go through. 2 go to through the numerators and denominator, we have 539/864 as our answer. Example 4, 2 hunters P and Q fire the target. Probability that hunter P and Q hit a target are 2/7 and 4/8 respectively. The bullet is fired once. Find the probability that both hit the target, both miss the target, only hunter Q miss the target, either one of them hit the target. Solution: we are given from the question probability that P hit the target, P sub H is 2/7, right? The probability that Q hits the target, Q sub H is given to us as 5/8. Next, we look for probability that P missed the target, which will be 1/2/7. Is that okay? And that gives us 5/7. Also, probability that Q will miss the target will be 1/5/8, which will give us 3/8. Okay? So A part of the question, probability that both hit the target means probability that P hit times probability that Q hit. Multiply both of them together. 2/7 times 5/8 it gives us 10/56, which is 5/28 when you reduce it down. Probability that both miss to be P miss times Q also miss. Okay, so that will give us 5/7 times 3/8, which is 15/56 when you multiply them. C part, probably that only Q miss means Q miss times P hit. So P hits the target. Okay? So that will be 3/8 times 2/7, which will give us 6/56. When you reduce it, you have 3/28. Okay? C part of the question, probability that either one hit simply means P hits, all right, and then Q will miss, plus or Q will hit and P will miss. That's what it means. Okay, so we're going to just substitute our values that we have already. So 2/7 times 3/8 plus 5/8 times 5/7. So multiply, we have 6/56 plus 25/56. When you add, you are going to have 31/56 as our answer. Addition rule of probability. If A and B are mutually exclusive outcomes of a random experiment, probability that A or B will occur is the sum of their probability. So probability of A or B equals probability of A plus probability of B, which we can abbreviate as probability of A union B equals probability of A plus probability of B. If the two outcomes A and B of a random process are not mutually exclusive, probability that A or B or both will occur is probability of A or B or both equals probability of A or probability of B minus probability of A and B, which we can abbreviate as probability of A union B equals probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. We can use it to solve problems. Let's try an example. One more example. Example 5. Probability of an outcome A is 1 over 4. Probability of B is 1 over 3. Probability of A or B or both is 1 over 2. What is the probability of A and B? We're going to use our formula. Probability of A union B equals probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. Is that okay? Probability of A union B is given to us as 1 over 2 from the question equals probability of A is 1 over 4. Probability of B 1 over 3 minus probability of A intersection B. That's what we are looking for. So remove A intersection B to the other side and bring the 1 over 2 inside. We're going to have 1 over 4 plus 1 over 3 minus 1 over 2. Is that okay? So look for the LCM. LCM of 4, 3, and 2 will be 12. So 4 into 12 will give us 3. Okay. Plus 3 into 12 will give us 4, minus 2 into 12 will give us 6. So if we add, we're going to have 1 over 12 as our final answer. I hope that is very clear. All right, you're going to do the following exercise and send to us because we would like to know how you understand the topic. All right, probability of 3 independent event A, B, and C occurring are 2 over 5, 1 over 3, and 3 over 5. Combine the probability that only 2 of the event occurs. The class consists of 25 boys, 15 girls. 2 students are to be chosen at random. Combine the probability that the 2 students are of the same sex. Just like that. 1, 2, and 3. And then there are other questions. Okay. Number 4. Probability that a certain student failed an examination is 2 over 3. If 3 students are selected at random, find the probability that they all pass the exam. They all fail the exam. At least 2 pass the exam. At most 2 pass the exam. Exactly 2 pass the exam. Okay. Question number 5. The number is selected at random from each of the sets, first set and second set. What is the probability that the sum of the number will be less than 7 but greater than 3? Number 6. All right. Ensure you solve the question. Follow the examples that we have gone through and then solve the questions. You can make a comment in the comment section of how it was easy for you to solve them. We'd like to hear from you. Okay. Question number 6. And then finally we have the last question. Probability of an outcome A is 1 over 3, B is 1 over 2, probability of A or B or both is 1 over 6. What's the probability of both A and B? For more of our videos, ensure you subscribe to this channel. Thanks for being a part of the class.